If you have just started with Calamity, there's gonna be a lot of things that are really overwhelming for you, especially the amount of items that you get and the progression. So this video is gonna aim to give a solid, spoiler-free beginning guide, and I'm gonna try to make it as short as possible so that you can watch the video and get back to playing right away. There will be timestamps in the description, so if you just want to skip to a certain part, you can. Alright, so in the beginning, you're going to be spawning with a starter bag. It has a lot of items that are aimed to make the beginning less sluggish and slow. And the most important thing are gonna be the difficulty items in there, because there's gonna be Deathmold, Revengeance, Defiled, and Ironheart, and there's even more difficulties that you can craft later down the line. What's important here is the only things you should pay attention to are Revengeance and Deathmold. If you're planning, like if this is your very first playthrough and you're planning to just experience the mods to the fullest degree but without any kind of insane difficulty, I would definitely recommend Revengeance. And for the first playthrough, I would just wouldn't go death mode. Like, death mode is difficult, and I would recommend it for second playthroughs and afterwards. In the first one, definitely go Revengeance. You're not gonna miss out on a lot, because Revengeance is the main difficulty, and it's just much more fun than expert mode. The other difficulties are mainly meant for farming, even though people are doing entire playthroughs on them. But stuff like the Defiled and Ironheart, just read the description, decide if you wanna use it. Don't do it on your first playthrough though. Literally only go Revengeance, and maybe use Defiled for farming, but just make sure to only have Revengeance for boss fights. I would also recommend to go into mod configuration, which you can really easily do over the menu and go through all of the configs. There's a lot of settings that are really important, like disabling enemy spawns near your town or like, you know, your home. And I would also go through the custom bindings, because there's actually a lot of things that you should bind before you start with Calamity, like Rage and Adrenaline. Speaking of which, Rage and Adrenaline are the two bars that are gonna appear on the top left when you start Revengeance or Death Mode. And to keep it simple, Rage is gonna build up when you take damage just at any point. And once it's completely filled up, you can use it for 5 seconds of increased damage. And Adrenaline works the same, but it only builds up in a boss fight if you don't get hit. The moment you get hit, it's gonna reset to 0. And if you manage to fill it up in a boss fight and use it, you're gonna get an even bigger damage boost. Both of them can be upgraded throughout the game. It is on you to find the upgrades. Before you get confused, as a summoner, you want to make sure to always have your summoner weapon in your hand, because having another weapon from another class in your hand is gonna reduce your summoner damage so that you cannot stack, like, I don't know, 10 summons and then still go ranger and have like an insane damage output. You do want to be careful with that, especially if you're going pure summoner. Make sure to not have any other weapons that you can accidentally switch to. And then finally, it's important to note that Calamity changes a lot of things on vanilla, so if something seems off or different, that's probably gonna be Calamity. And it's worth checking out the Calamity page on the vanilla changes, but only do it after your first playthrough, so you keep the blind aspect, because a lot of the changes are really, really good. I would also say it's pretty much mandatory to use the recipe browser and the boss checklist, because I will be explaining the progression, but there's gonna be things that you have to figure out yourself. And it's much easier to just open up the recipe browser, check what kind of armor or weapons you can make at the moment, or use the boss checklist to find out how to summon a boss and when to fight bosses, just in case any kind of confusion comes up. I would also highly recommend that you use the wiki a lot, because the wiki is just really good, it's well designed, it's updated most of the time. And if you have any more questions, my Discord and the Calamity Discord are gonna be happy to help you. Before you have defeated any boss, you can farm Wolfram enemies for their gear, you can find shrines in the underground, you can explore planetoids in the sky, and you can farm for strong pre-boss weapons and equipment in the underground desert. After you have defeated King Slime, you should go and fight Desert Scorch. Beating him gives you full access to the Sunken Sea. Go and find it, it is one of the best biomes in the game, and it has a mini-boss that will give you a new NPC. Beating Isle of Cthulhu is gonna unlock the Acid Rain event, which will start on the ocean behind your dungeon. When you're done farming the Acid Rain, you should seek a mushroom biome and use glowing mushrooms to make a spawner. After that would be Eater of Worlds and Brain of Cthulhu, and then Hive Mind and Perforator depending on what evil you're in. Just be careful with what you kill in those biomes if you don't want an accidental boss fight. After beating Hive Mind or Perforator, you can go and farm for Aerospec armor in the undergrounds, and you can also go and look for Draedon's Labs, which are hidden deep in the underground and above the clouds. Once you're done raiding the dungeon and beating Skeleton, and you got yourself a Shadow Key, you should go back to the biome that you farmed the Acid Rain in, and go into the Abyss, which is a scary and dark biome hidden below the surface of the ocean that you farmed the Acid Rain in. Focus on the chests for now, because you cannot really do anything, and don't go too deep into the biome. With bones from the dungeon, you can make pre-hard mode wings, which will help you against the next boss, Slime God. Once defeated, you can gain access to the Statigel armor and weapons. When you're in hard mode, you have a lot of options. You can either go back to the Sunken Sea and fight the mini-boss and enemies again for new and stronger weapons, or you can check out the ice biome for special enemies and special drops from them. It will allow you to craft the spawner for Cryogen. The underground is also worth exploring, and so is the very left side of hell for another unique pre-mechanical boss. Don't miss out on this one. On top of that, you can also find a new infection in your world, which offers an amazing view and really good music, but also a good Auroch armor set for the time being. Killing Cryogen will spawn Cryonic Ore, and therefore grant you access to the Daedalus gear. And if you want to upgrade the Acid Rain event, You can go to the biome from earlier that you farmed the acid rain in and wait for a passive friend. Shooting him will start the fight, and killing him upgrades the acid rain to tier 2, dropping better weapons and spawning mini bosses. After the mechanical bosses, you can now face Calamitous, one of the big names. Killing her will upgrade the Abyss to the next tier, making enemies drop materials used to make a really strong weapon. At this point, the new infection has a boss for you to fight. Craft his spawner by collecting Stardust. Beating him will make the enemies in the biome drop a ton of new weapons. Killing Golem will make ore in the Abyss mineable, allowing you to get hydrothermic armor and gear, and it will also call a plague to hit the jungle. Go and find out what the plague is about. It has an amazing boss to offer, a ranger and summoner armor, and much more. And while you're in the temple, take some lizard blocks for you. One of the bosses that is coming up needs it, and is one of the best bosses to farm in the game. After defeating Cultist, you can take on the Pest of the Cosmos and the Calamity Infection, find an altar and make a sacrifice to start his fight. This will allow you to make astral armor for Moonlord. Killing Moonlord will change the Hollowed in Hell and cause new threats to appear, which are worth hunting because they drop important stuff such as materials for the next spawner, which will spawn sort of a mini-boss that drops yet another spawner for the actual bigger evil. If you went rogue, you can make Empyrean armor after Moonlord, which is basically the Luminite armor but for rogue. Solar Fragments combined with Luminite buffs will allow you to create something known for attracting a very dangerous animal in the jungle. You should go and check that out. And then using the spawner you get dropped from the bosses before in either Hell or Hollow during the day, or during night if you're confident enough, will spawn the Profaned Goddess. Beating her drops a special rune, use it in Hell, Space, and the dungeon to see what happens. And while you're in the dungeon, killing 30 of those new spirits and making a spawn out of their drops spawns a new but really challenging boss that is worth defeating, as it upgrades the Abyss to tier 3, allowing you to kill the mini bosses at the bottom for crazy strong weapons and 2 new armor sets. It also upgrades Acid Rain to tier 3, spawning what is a contender for the hardest boss in the game at the moment, at the end of the event. Be well prepared. The materials dropped from the rune will allow you to make the Cosmic Worm, which spawns yet another new boss that only has one phase. Killing that boss will upgrade the Pumpkin and Frost Moon and make the mini bosses in there drop new materials, which are used to craft Godslayer armor and the Fearmonger set if you're a summoner. As your second to last challenge, you will be asked to craft a dragon egg and use it in the jungle. Be careful and read what he says in chat, you need to prove you're worthy before you can fight the whole fight first. You will also gain access to the silver armor and an upgraded solar eclipse. After overcoming this challenge, you can farm for auric armor and extra tier weapons, which you should guarantee do. Your last challenge is an upgrade of the Calamitous spawner from hard mode. This boss is incredibly difficult, so good luck on your journey. And if you're still not done after that, if you want a even bigger challenge, at the bottom of the Abyss there's a secret intended for the absolute endgame, like the very end. So go and check that out. And that's all for the beginner guide. I hope I could help you with this. If there's any more questions, then ask in the comments. And if there's anything I missed, then let me know.